Hey there, welcome to Kid Squid Studios, where it all comes together. Today we're actually going to be looking at the Tello drone.
There's a problem. I was doing a test run with the drone,
and it is stuck
right there.
Boom. So I'm gonna have to throw things.
Strike! Strike!
Yes?
You're out!
Okay, so it looks like I found both of the propellers here, but one of them, look, it's got a chip in it, but this one looks intact. So we can get back to it. I need to get some more propellers because I know I'm gonna break and lose them because I crash a lot. Okay, so this is a great example of its ruggedness. It lost two propellers when I was trying to get it out of the tree. And every time you're like, there it goes, drone's gone forever. But then you just start chucking shit at it and it comes back down. But let's go ahead and get these propellers on there and get it back in the air.
Looks like somebody else lost a drone late too, but this thing is huge. Alrighty, there we go. All put back together. And I bet you anything, it's gonna start right up.
So, it's obviously not a racing drone, but it can go fast. It's not a stunt drone, but it can do stunts. And it's not a videography drone, even though it can shoot video. So, is it worth it? That's the big question here. And the answer is yeah. Yeah, hell yeah, it's worth it. As a toy, as an introduction to drones, getting over crashing drones and not worrying about it so much because it's gonna happen. Like any tool or toy or utensil, it's gonna get hurt eventually. So getting over that quicker is a better thing. So when you step up to a better drone, you'll be able to do a better job with it. Okay, so let's talk about the pros and the cons real quick. Obviously, first the pros. It's fun, it's easy to use, it's beginner friendly. Even the setup itself is actually really easy. It's beginner friendly too, the downloading and getting everything set up and ready to go. I'm sorry, I saw a weird orange spider running around my backpack there. Well, and it being small and light means it's very portable. It's hardy. For being a light little plastic thing, it's pretty hardy. I crash it constantly. It gets the crap beat out of it, you put it back together, and it flies right away. It hasn't had any issues. It's gotten hung up on a million things. It's crashed into things hard as hell, too. It being $130, I think that's reasonable for what you're getting. You get to play with a drone that is kind of a crossover between like, oh, do I want to fly it like trick-wise and speed-wise, or do I want to fly it more along the lines of trying to get really good footage? But you get to try out the drone without actually having to spend a bunch of money. So let's go ahead and talk about the cons. Obviously, the biggest one is the wind. Any type of breeze, it is not a happy camper. Honestly, this is better for around the house and in the yard and things like that, or in a big open field if there's no wind.
It is a relatively breezy day.
So this is me without touching it at all. See, but then the wind takes it. See, I'm not touching it. The wind takes off with it. And the signal recording is not great. So on top of it just being the 720p, it also does not do well in low light situations. The sensor inside, I mean, we're talking, the sensor's gotta be like this little tiny thing, and they're making a really cheap drone for us to play with. It's not going to have the best sensor on the planet. And it also gets signal interference from any kind of Wi-Fi, like if you're close to any apartment buildings or school or power wires or anything like that, it immediately starts complaining about it. Then whenever it comes to the recording once again, the camera's fixed, which means that you can't move the camera up. So if you go in fast mode and you go real fast, it just tilts down and looks at the ground the whole time, and you can't really see where you're going or what you're doing.
There's the throw and go. It also does flips. It auto turns 360 degrees. There's the circle around the object setting that I really like. And the up and away. This one, the bounce, I really don't see how you would use that. I mean, it's just a silly thing.
I would show you what it looks like when there is a breeze, which is what people typically don't show you because they want to show you really good, smooth footage. I'm going to show you real footage. And you'll also see the lag in the signal because it does not record onto an SD drive in the actual drone. It records back to your phone. So that is reliant on the signal between the two. You can get signal boosters and things like that, but then you're spending enough money to buy a better drone, you know, at this point. See, it's fighting the wind the whole time. Down and come underneath the wind. So we might go ahead and try to use the wind. What happened right there was the wind took off with it. And we'll start a new recording. So, that's what it's like trying to capture a more cinematic shot in slightly breezy situations. We're gonna go ahead and take this whole thing over to another place where there's less wind. I came out here to this open area because it's easier to fly a drone in an open area, first off. Second off, I wanted to show you what the wind was like and how it really affects the flyability of the drone.
Like here, when you're trying to navigate between trees in a windy situation, and you try to compensate for the wind, and then the drone tries to compensate for the wind, and it ends up shooting out and flying into the tree anyway.
So let's go ahead and go to another place, which is right around the corner here, and there's a big circle of trees, and it should block the wind, and we should be able to get a better sense of what kind of shots you can get in a less windy environment. Okay, so that one was perfect, I think. I may be pushing my luck trying to get a second shot, but... I know I'm really pushing my luck this time. All right, we were super fortunate. Not only did we get a third shot without crashing or losing the drone, we also got the benefit of the train going by, and we'll see what that looks like. I'm excited. Yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed looking at the Tello drone with me, and I hope these kind of concepts helped you make a decision on what kind of drone you want to get, or if you want to get a kind of a crossover all-around beginner drone like this to get your feet wet, which I definitely recommend before stepping up to a pro drone. I hope this was fun. Please, till next time, stay safe, keep creative, and we'll see you right back here at Kid Squid Studios, where it all comes together.